So pull up. Got it? You know what I'm saying?
Wait, can you do one more time?
So I
make sure you get the Uggs slippers.
So I call a saddle dribble, right? A saddle dribble, and then I'm going forward, boom, right? So obviously with less dribbles. So boom, boom, boom. All right? My ear Uggs, like that? I'm making this popular. Don't call it a comeback.
I had to delete my Instagram just because that's all I saw when I would go on was everyone else playing, and it was me like sitting on the couch rehabbing and trying to bend my leg when everyone else was getting to do what I wanted to.
The first day I told her, I said, just be sad, like do what you want to do, feel bad for yourself, be sad, cry, be mad, be whatever. And then from here on out, like tomorrow we'll wake up and you just attack it.
Honestly, it's not really like a timetable type of thing. Like my doctor wasn't like a 6 months, then you can run, then you can do this. It was how your body's feeling, how you're progressing. So I felt good. I was on top of all my rehab. I was doing shooting, I was fully practicing. So I felt good, my body felt fine. So it's like, why not try it out a little bit at a time? And I felt good, so we went with it.
Her, one of the most underrated parts of her game that people don't appreciate or recognize is her footwork. Her footwork is immaculate. Her pity pat into her shot is very, very close in timing. And we had somebody break this down for us. Very, very close in timing to Steph and Clay. And one summer we just watched a lot of video of Steph and Clay, and we went in the gym every day and we worked on that quick 1-2, the quick 1-2 into that release to get that release point quicker, because she was such a weapon on the floor that she was being guarded so closely that she needed that to get shots off when the defense was right on top of her. And so that's one of the things that's really, really overlooked. Katie developed her shot. That's Katie's shot.
I mean, I didn't give it to her, but I taught it to her. One of the things that I preach when I do basketball clinics is, we do a little math lesson of, if you spent 10 minutes a day working on your ball handling, and you gave yourself one day off a week, so that's 6 days a week of 10 minutes. How long is that? So if you've got 1 hour a week and 52 weeks in a year, how many hours do you have? Oh, 52. So you're telling me in 52 hours of focused work that you wouldn't be an like astronomically better ball handler a year from today than you are right now. And it's 10 minutes a day. So I think some people get the impression that you gotta spend 3, 4, 5 hours a day, and it really, you don't to be great. It just is consistent effort over time. And so for Azzi, she was able to start young.
Hi.
It drives me crazy when people say, oh, of course Azzi's good. Look at her parents. That's just what happens. And it's not.
We need to do this one, Chris. Saw this one time when we visited a school. They had like a big version, and my mom was like, oh, this is so cool. And my dad got it for her for Christmas a few years ago. It's a family Christmas gift. So.
That's actually really cool.
My brothers would do this too. We'll do this. Like, it's really nice on snow days too. It's a little messy. Don't judge. I got these for my cousins when I tore my ACL. They say different things on them.
Oh, that's so cute.
I've already eaten three. And then there's a lot going on in this bag, but.
Do you hear any telelicking?
Oh. Wait a minute. Yes, I always. with me.
Into that.
Oh my God, no.
Let me see. It's almost gone. Would you like chocolate sauce or anything on it?
Chocolate sauce?
Chocolate syrup? Hershey's syrup? I don't know, it just came out, okay? Yeah, you know, I could have gone pro receiver, pro safety, but basketball's got my heart. I went to Florida for the flag football national championships. Got to go to the Pro Bowl, and we won, and we got to go to Ohio for the Hall of Fame.
Yeah.
Oh, when they gave me my banner for being the player of the year, Gatorade also gave my mom a banner because she was the Gatorade player of the year for her state when she was in high school, but they didn't have banners back then. So she got her banner, it's hanging downstairs next to mine, and I think she might have cried when she got it. Like, it was really sweet of them to do that. These were the shoes that him and the Mambas were wearing when I first met them all, and I watched them all play, that's what they were wearing. So my goal is when I go back out to LA, I want all of the other Mamba girls to sign these for me. No, they were good. I mean, you could tell that they were young, but their IQ was, I've never seen young girls with such a high IQ. And once the girls now too, once that they like learn like the feel for their body and really the feel for the game, they're gonna be really good. Like, I was at practice with them. And it was just a skills practice. They were just like going over moves. He would like show them like their fadeaway. He was going over the fadeaway. And I was partners with Gigi. We're at the same basket. And I'm like, what foot? Like, I'm like trying to get it right. I'm missing every shot. And Gigi just like swishing everything. And she's like, right foot, left foot back. Like, no, but they're a really good group of girls. I don't even know what word you could use to describe him, just the type of person he was. Like, not even basketball related, just he cared about you as a whole, so. Like, when I first met him, I wasn't sure, like, what I was gonna get, and he just came over, gave me a hug, and I'm like, Mom, oh my gosh, Kobe just gave me a hug, but he was super down to earth. He followed me on Instagram, and then I was going out for visits in the ESPNW Women's Summit. And so I texted him, I said, I'll be in the area. Is there any way I can work out? He's like, yeah, of course. Just let me know when. You're always welcome.
And he just said that he was taking some video, and he came back, and we were talking a little bit more. And he was like, yo, Azzi got that red dot. Like, here's, in my opinion, one of the top two players in the world ever, saying that my daughter has a laser for a shot. And he was just saying how he appreciated how much she worked hard, and just the representation that she had in terms of being a young leader to young kids looking up to her, and Gigi being one of them. You know, he just had some really complimentary things to say, which is, I'll never forget. So one of the most awesome moments, basketball moments, of my life.
Kobe was someone that I really looked up to, and I am beyond grateful that I got the chance to meet him and work out with him. I'm about to cry. Those are things that I'll never forget. Like, he really cared about women's basketball, so everything he was doing, and the fact that he like was trying to give back, and I don't know. My thoughts are kind of jumbled right now about him. But just, he was an amazing person and player. Like, you can't ever limit him to say he was just a great player or just a great person. He was all around great in every aspect, and what he was doing for the game was incredible. But I like this one. This one is probably my favorite. I think that really I think that shows who Kobe was, too. He inspired a lot of people.
Do you ever have girls, like, or some anybody DM you, say you inspire them?
Yeah, actually, those are the best. Like, I respond to almost all of those. Those are my, it's like one of my favorite things, actually. My favorite thing for Christmas was, there was this girl, her dad went to school with my mom, and his daughter is a fan of mine. They live in North Carolina. And so he messaged her on Facebook and said, my daughter's a big fan of AC. Is there any way she can, like, sign a picture of her and send it for Christmas? She would love that. And so he sent a video of her opening it, and it was, I cried. It was so cute. Seeing that younger kids already look up to me, it pushes me to be great. Like, I want to be great role models for them, and I want to continue being like a great person and player so that they can keep looking up to me. I hope to be remembered not just by my game. Of course, like, I want to be great. I want to be one of the greatest. So I hope people remember me with that. But I hope that I'm remembered as like a really good teammate and someone that pushed people to be their best selves that they could be. And even off the court, hope that I'm able to push people and give back. I don't think that I have updated this. So I do, it's just these things. I do a clinic every year. I started in eighth grade for like a project, and then I've done one every year since. My great-grandmother passed away from Alzheimer's, so I hold a clinic and it's free. I accept donations and everything goes to Pat Summit Alzheimer Foundation. So it's fun to work with the younger kids, but giving to a bigger cause. I know I don't really contribute that much, but it's thought that counts, what we're doing that counts. The recruiting process is good. It was weird when they first started texting and calling us, but it's good. I've built a lot of really good relationships with coaches and even some of their players.
How are you?
Look at that husky.
Oh my gosh.
Azzi Fudd is the best player in the country, the best shooter.
Hey, Paige, how you doing?
What's up? She doesn't miss. I mean, we talk about it a lot, but she needs to come to the Huskies. We compete every day in practice. We compete on who gets to practice first, who is in the weight room more, who gets up more shots. And if she goes to another team, we're only competing against each other one game a year. Like, do the math. Come on. Azzi, you know what to do. Everybody in the country knows what she should do. It's a simple decision.
NCAA championships and doing it. And we'll also be able to make TikToks. And we're just gonna push each other and practice every day. And I'm gonna try to beat her into the gym, and she's gonna try to beat me into the gym. And then we're gonna make each other stronger in the weight room. And yeah, we'll just have a lot of fun. No pitch.
I'm calling Gino on three-way. I mean, on FaceTime, like, he's got to see this. You got your star recruit in here trying to do recruiting pitches for you.
They got to watch your UConn deal.
Your UConn pitch.
Yeah, your pitch. They loved it. They said to Azzi, like, what's your choice, man? Come on, man. This girl's going to give you 20 points every game.
Guaranteed.
And TikTok.
So all right.
Paige is a better dancer than Azzi?
What?
Why?
I'm a better TikToker. You're a better, like, regular dancer. Tell me, that is true.
No, because if I learn to TikTok, then if we like learn at the same time, then I'm gonna be better at shooting him.
It's a cheap way to get famous.
But hey, you're all white. You don't have any of the rhythm in you.
AZ's white.
Yeah, my side of the family.
She's a little more black than me. My family is a mess. We are like a big melting pot. We're a lot of fun. You guys saw all of our sides. You got to see, you guys got to see the real Fudd family this weekend. Yeah, John! Yeah, good job, John! Just please not last place.
Jose, I miss you, man. You were my guy. This guy here preps food. He's my chef boyardee.
Who's happy about the Nine Papa? It's a little dry, but it's really good.
It's really dry?
Why did I just have this dry?
What's your favorite thing to see her do?
Score?
Duh.
You don't love me?
I do.
Oh, God. I'm embarrassing him. Oh, prime mom, for sure. Prime mom will cut her heart out. It's the same thing.
It says espresso.
Galva chip, espresso chip, same thing.
No, it's the same thing. Chocolate is disgusting, so it's really nice.
Well, you're disgusting, so...